The first half of 2019 saw some of the best investment gains in a decade, breaking a number of records. Hello, I'm Ken Homan with Central Trust Company. Welcome to the Central View, our quarterly market update. As we enter the third quarter, let's take a look back at what shaped the first half of the year and preview our outlook for the remainder of 2019. Let's get started. The first half of 2019 saw many types of investments, including stocks and bonds, post their strongest gains in a decade. A number of records are set on the investment front, including the strongest January stock market rally since 1987 and record highs in the U.S. equity markets for June and continued on into July. Coupled with the lowest unemployment rate since 1969, we now have the longest U.S. economic expansion on record. We started the year with the Federal Reserve pausing its three-year-old program of tightening interest rates. This was in response to evidence which showed a slowing of global economic growth. That major policy shift by the Fed boosted investor sentiment and market abruptly changed direction in January after an extremely weak fourth quarter of last year. The equity markets recorded consecutive gains in January, February, March, and again in April as the talk of an impending recession dissipated. Markets were rattled in May, however, as the U.S. implemented tariffs on $200 billion of Chinese goods. The unknown of how the trade talks will progress and the threat of additional tariffs continue to be the darkest cloud over our market outlook and will be closely watched going forward. As we enter the third quarter, the Fed is preparing the markets for a possible rate cut in late July and/or early fall. Why the need for a rate cut? GDP growth in the U.S. as well as in the majority of other developed economies is slowing. Tariffs and continued trade disputes are responsible for much of the weakness in global manufacturing activity and represents the clearest risk to global growth. Leading indicators such as surveys of purchasing managers and the relationship of long interest rates to short interest rates are still mixed, but are trending to suggest the risk of a continued broad global slowdown is growing. A rate cut in the U.S. should be enough to support a reversal in our growth trajectory. After all, labor markets continue to be strong with an unemployment rate at a five-year low of 3.7%, and wages are growing at a healthy pace of 3.4%. These are well above the rate of inflation, but less than the prior levels that have spurred the Fed to raise rates to shut off economic growth. Household net worth is at an all-time record high. Corporate balance sheets are strong and earnings are slowing but continue to grow. And maybe most importantly, productivity growth continues to build and grow. This could ultimately relieve inflationary pressures for wages from wage growth and provide a platform for another stage of economic growth that could continue well into the next decade. If you have questions about your investments, we encourage you to reach out to your Central Trust Company portfolio manager. And for more information on the markets and our views, be sure to visit centraltrust.net.